Hi Capricorn, welcome to this reading. You might find it resonates more though if this is your moon or rising sign, but let's see. So, what do we have here? The Three of Pentacles. Okay. So this person could be working on a plan. They could be, their focus could be on building something. This could be building something with you. Let me see, let's keep going. So what do they want to say to you? We have the Fool. If your person is very weighed down with work or dealing with other people, situations that require their attention, they don't necessarily want to give their attention to these people or situations. They're dreaming of liberation. We have Aries energy here. But they're saying, I wish I could just run away and, you know, I don't even want to pack a bag. I'll just deal with whatever I've got with me, you know, and make it work. Eight of Swords in reverse. So your person could be saying that they're feeling quite tied up right now by life, by their 3D world, by their work or commitment, and they're dreaming of freedom. Yeah, look at this, King of Pentacles. This is someone who a lot of people, or maybe people who are important in their life, like children, a boss, employee, something like that. People look up to this person, depend on them. This might be, you know, your person. They might be someone here who has built a very nice life for themselves, but it requires maintenance, as in, I feel some of you saying, well, whose life doesn't? And I agree with you. But let's say they have a lot of money, a very nice house. They have to keep on top of things, or very quickly they get swamped underneath. Or if they have a very important position at work, or it's a position of authority, they can't just sit back and catch up tomorrow, you know, because they'll be snowed under instantly. So this seems to be someone that in one way or another they have, or at least feel that they have, a lot of responsibility. There's no time for them to have a rest. I mean, I feel there's always time for a rest, even if you have to schedule it, you know, in the future at some point. But this person's saying not right now. And they're doing lots of daydreaming, lots of fantasizing about being able to just throw all of these responsibilities away and be free. Someone might like sailing, or they may have a boat or a yacht, something like that. Or that could be a dream, that could be a goal. Maybe they're saying, when I retire, I'll do that. Or, you know, I wish on the weekends I could go sailing more, or I don't know, something like that. So we have, like I said, Aries energy here. We have Taurus as well. So that could be in your chart, could be in their chart. Okay, yeah, look at this, the Nine of Wands. You see, they're exhausted. This is how it looks on the surface. Three of Coins, they're keeping it together, being a team player, it's all good. But this is how they're actually feeling underneath, absolutely just frazzled, exhausted, tired. Okay, let's see what else we have. Five of Pentacles. This person, do you see what I mean? They have this fear. I do feel it's a slightly irrational fear that if they give themselves any downtime, time off, time to rest, everything will just fall apart. We go from, you know, being in control, King of Pentacles, to just, you know, having lost some money or lost something, or, you know, you feel suddenly you're on the outside of things. You're not in the center. You're not in control. There's some sort of a feeling of lack. This could be someone who has some sort of control issues, or they derive a sense of grounding from being in control or having responsibilities and things they need to do all the time. So maybe right now your person's a bit disconnected from what's going on in their inner world because of this. This could also be an escape tactic as well. So we have the Knight of Wands in reverse. That's Sagittarius energy, but it's a desire for freedom, for travel, for adventure, for doing things that they do because they want to, not because they have to. Page of Cups in the reverse. So your person is saying, I haven't been in touch as much as I should. I haven't been in touch at all because I've been so busy. And I feel what you're saying is, that's no excuse. I'm busy too. Do you think I'm some sort of layabout? You know, I do things as well. We have the Star, and it's so interesting. This came out today in one of my personal readings, but even this morning before that, I was thinking about the energy of the Star, because the Star talks about hope, yes, healing. It talks about feeling divinely guided. It talks about inspiration. It talks about a determination to overcome obstacles, whatever comes up, because you know your ultimate goal. You have a belief that you're going to get there. So you start your journey and you're saying, whatever comes up, fine, I can deal with it. But The star is, if you think of stars in the sky, you see them at night time. So your person could be in this heavy place. They might even feel that they're in this darkness alone. They're carrying a lot by themselves. We see the stars better in areas that are not built up. So again, there's a lack of people around. So in some way, your person's saying, I'm alone in something I'm doing. I'm the only responsible one, or I'm the only one who can do whatever I'm doing, so people are depending on me. But it's almost like they need to be in that place. They need to go through this period in order to see clearly, to see the stars, to see their North Star. So perhaps your person needs to get to a place where they're completely exhausted, overworked, and they're forced to sit down and say, okay, let me see what's going on within. Let me connect to my intuition. Let me reset my compass here. Let me see where I'm really going. So there's something here about going through the darkness to get into or to see the light. And we're not talking about the sun. You know, the sun is glaringly obvious. You cannot ignore it. There's something more subtle here that spirit's trying to get your person to see. They've got to make space for this. There might be a point where your person works to exhaustion, or whatever they're doing, it exhausts them, and they need to have, you know, a couple of days in bed or something, or they get the flu. Nothing really serious, but just something to slow them down for a bit. And that gives them space to hear what's going on within. We have Aquarius energy with the star. Because, yeah, I mean, everyone's busy, you know, but I don't think that's an excuse for not reaching out or for not responding. Let's see if they've got anything else to say about this. Okay, yeah, Six of Pentacles. They're saying, do you know how many people want my time and my attention? And you're saying, well, yes, I'm one of them. Am I not important enough to get any? We have the Two of Wands in reverse, and we have the Five of Swords. So what I will say, the people they are giving time and attention to, it just feels very businessy. It feels like it's work. It's something to do with chores or responsibility, something like that. It's not, you know, really friends, or it could be family members, but if they are, they consider these family members to be a burden in some way. The communication they're having is leading to more stress, anxiety, possibly arguments. I don't think they're really spending much time doing things that are nice or enjoyable. So the message they keep coming up with is, I'm so busy, I'm so busy, I wish I wasn't. I wish I could just turn around, run away and be free. Okay. Let's see what else they want to say. Okay, you've done nothing wrong. I'm just figuring things out. I love you. I want you. I'm coming for you. Please be just a bit more patient with me. I'll make this up to you later. So they do, it seems like they're juggling a lot, and they're saying, yes, when I have a moment, when I can catch my breath, I will, you know, reach out, respond, take some action, whatever they're needing to do here. Turns out you were right. My ego's bruised, but I ultimately want you in my life more than I need to be right. I just have to swallow my pride a minute, as I'm not used to this feeling. Okay, so this is someone who does like to be in control. They do like to be right. I feel that often they are right. You know, the King of Pentacles is someone who is reliable, someone who is wise. Turns out they met their match with you, they met their equal, and perhaps they kept trying to push you into this Page of Pentacles position, and you were like, no, I'm your equal, stop being ridiculous. Why can't we just meet halfway? So it's taken them some adjusting, because look, they're used to people needing them, they're used to having to do everything by themselves. That could even be a reason they might have pushed this away to begin with. They might have been saying, I can't have one more situation on my hands where another person needs something from me, you know, before they really got to know you and to understand this connection. I'm not talking to you because I tend to sabotage myself and don't want to hurt you. I'm working on healing, believing, and becoming more confident in myself so I can open up to this caliber of love. Exactly, you see? They haven't experienced something like this before, something that really truly is equal. And here we have the healing that is incoming. Okay. So let's get some lover's oracle messages. We have. I believe this is the soulmate card. Yes. Your soulmate is already with you in spirit. Believe this and they will manifest physically. So this person feels that you are their soulmate. I'm not sure if they use that terminology, you know, soulmate, twin flames, but they feel it. That's how they feel. They feel this depth of connection with you, a very natural, automatic, intuitive connection. Okay, here is the second card. It says emotions are a natural and necessary part of life, but they can also distort your perception and cloud your vision. In order to see things clearly, you must let go of resentment. Yeah, this person has got to let go of this feeling of it's always me and I have to do everything by myself. Especially as that's not even relevant to your connection. You know, you've never been a burden on them and they're not even saying you have been. So they kind of need to stop treating you maybe like that if they have been to some extent. Like, you know, maybe in some ways this is another thing for them to have to carry, because it's not. It's more of a blessing here, you know, to have an equal partner. Okay, and we have deep in your heart, you already know the answer, do what feels right. Yeah, this is what's coming, excuse me. This is what is coming to them. Maybe they're struggling to admit this to you with my throat closing up like that. But yeah, they know that this is incredible, that actually they can slow down just for a bit, just for a minute, and there's no need to kind of to push this away or to be fearful, because I feel there's fear mixed in with this as well. You know, I have to stay on top of everything. My world will collapse if I don't, if I allow myself to do something that feels good rather than pursue my responsibilities or put responsibilities first all the time, then I'm bad. You know, maybe they were shown that growing up, that you can't really have time for fun. You always have to put other people first. You always have to prioritize your responsibilities or you're failing. You know, you won't get acknowledgement from us, your parents, if you don't do this, that kind of thing. Okay, so whatever cards come out, red or blue, my intention is today that they will all be messages to you from your person. But of course, you can set another intention if you wish, you know, if you want to align with one color or the other. Okay, I have never experienced a love and a connection like this before. Please don't give up on me. And that's exactly the same as this card here, talking about never having experienced this caliber of love before. Okay, do you really believe I am the one for you? So they may have had people in the past that were attracted to their success or their wealth, or if they're very physically attractive, you know, they've got something here. They're a king, so they've got something they've accumulated, some kind of abundance, whatever form it's taking. And maybe people have been attracted to that in the past, but then they've got to know your person and thought, yeah, maybe not. And now your person's saying, is this real? Do you really see me for me and not what's around me? I'm considering moving on with a soulmate, but I really don't want to have to. Okay, so this could be for those of you where there is a third party and they're trying to say to themselves, you know, do I go again with what I feel I should do, with what my family or society expects me to do, or do I go with my heart? Maybe what they have been doing is sticking with this other person, and spirit's saying, no, you know, you need to really connect, you need to listen to that quiet voice in the darkness that you are drowning out with all of your busyness. Okay, we have, it's sometimes hard to keep the faith when you are taking so long to commit. I mean, that's so out there. I feel this is probably from you to them, if I'm honest. I mean, maybe for some of you, this is switched and you have been hesitant to commit to this person and they've been pursuing you. But given how this looks, kind of feel this is probably your voice here. I've been hurt so badly, I don't know if I can really love again. So, okay, fine. Maybe all of this busyness is a distraction as well from that, or from opening up. The hurt could be, as I said before, they haven't been seen for them, and then they've just been dropped when they've started to reveal themselves in the past. Okay, let's get some channeled messages. As I'm doing this reading, the sun has come out and I'm sweltering, if I'm honest with you. I feel there's something about this connection that makes your person feel under the spotlight. Maybe, as I said, you're the first person who really sees them and it's great, but it makes them feel very uncomfortable as well because they're not used to it. Or maybe they feel under pressure in some way. you know, if they do have to make a decision, or if they have to decide, okay, I'll cut back at work to make time for this, or I'll relocate, you know, whatever it is. We have he/she isn't good enough for you. So that's for those of you who are in your own commitment outside of this connection here, and your person is saying, yeah, they are not good enough for you. There might be some jealousy. Wish I could change your family and or friends. So yes, again, I wish I could get rid of your person. I wish I could, if there's no person, if you're single, but you know that there's some sort of tension between this person and your family or a friend or something like that. They're saying, I wish I could just sort of remove that person so they weren't an issue. Or your person here could be saying, I feel that your friends and family won't really accept me. I feel like they might not like me. We have faithful to you. So whatever else is going on in this person's life, you know, with that soulmate card, they do feel you, they feel the energy of this connection. And they're kind of saying, I've never really wanted to push this away. I've always held on to this in my heart space, which is why maybe at times you may have said, well, I need to move on, but you feel the connection very strongly because they never actually let you go, not deep down. We have overpower me. So this to me is the energy of someone who's saying, yes, I'm normally the one in charge and I'm tired. I wish, you know, secretly, I kind of wish you could just take charge for me and tell me what to do so I can just switch off for a minute. We have, yes, the posts are for you. So if you're seeing them post things on social media and you're wondering, is that for my benefit? It seems like it's related to our situation. That's confirmation for you. The overpower me, spirit's telling me as well, that could be something like a sexual message, something to do with the bedroom. Maybe they're saying, look, in life I'm very dominant, but when it comes to being in the bedroom, I have fantasies about being submissive to you. We have, yeah, look, unresolved father issues. I do feel for some of you, as your person was growing up, they were shown or told by a very strict masculine energy, or really made to believe through what they were shown that they were only really valued and appreciated when they were being responsible or working or doing something, you know, productive, not resting, not being silly, not having fun. Let's just be friends. I mean, you know, we will not be friends because that's not the feeling here. I do think they've tried to make this just a friendship in the past, and it's been very unsatisfactory for both of you. I keep seeing the card that says, I'm thinking of you right now. So they're thinking of you in this very moment. Suspicious, yes. So your person is suspicious. They have in the past judged you in this connection based on how other people have treated them. And I do feel that other people have been attracted to, as I said, what they have or some sort of glamour around them, especially having the star next to the King of Pentacles. This could be someone who is in the spotlight in some way, whether it's in a really big way or within their community, you know, so people have been attracted to that or a level of popularity or something like that. And we have call or message me. So yeah, this person's wanting you to reach out. You might be saying no because that's all I've been doing and you're ignoring me. I think that you reaching out to them reassures them and calms that part of them that is fearful, and also helps them to see that you really do feel that they're the one for you. But you, on the other hand, are feeling like, well, maybe I would like some reassurance back. I'm glad you see me as very strong, but doesn't mean I'm not human over here. You know, a bit of equal give and take would be very welcome. So I would say, yes, go ahead if you're wanting to, but if you don't want to reach out again, at least right now, then, you know, honor that feeling. Okay, so let's have a look at some traits and qualities about this person that you either know and can use as confirmation, or maybe something here that is a new thing or something they want you to know about them that you might not know yet. We have lives alone. So you might know this, or they're saying, I have actually moved out. Something has changed here. lives with others. Wow. Yeah. So they could be saying something's changing here with my home life, something you're unaware of. I'm moving out alone, or I'm moving in with some people. Maybe they're moving in with like a family member, or getting housemates or flatmates, depending on what their situation is. Or it could just be more generally saying something is changing in my home. You can't see it. You know, I go in, the door's closed, but something is going on there, something different that you don't know about. Lives close by. Are you kidding? This person wants to say something about their living situation, their house, the location. Maybe it's to do with you. Maybe you or they, someone here might be moving and they're saying, I want us to live close by, or I'm moving closer to you. Something is really changing though, with their actual home, their house. We have smoker. So maybe they smoke, maybe they're saying I'm doing something as maybe a form of a coping mechanism, a form of release. I don't know, something like that. Or maybe they just smoke, like I said. We have student. So they could be learning something new in a formal way. They could be learning something about themselves or an experience, seeing something differently. We have dedicated to a hobby, and now I'm being drawn back to sailing or being by the water, on the water. Struggling financially. Yeah, so for some of you, if your person lived alone, you might be saying there's no way, I cannot see them having housemates or flatmates. And they might be saying, well, I've taken in a lodger or something like that because something's going on at work. I don't know, who knows. But they do have money concerns, and we have non-smoker. It's amazing how often smoker and non-smoker comes out. They're trying to make some sort of a change here, a positive change. I think it's a bit like, you know, two steps forward, one step back, but they're getting there. I'm seeing lots of distraction here, maybe giving too much attention to forms of escapism. Lots of probably unnecessary worries about money. If your person is very wealthy or they're very stable, they could, one of the things that drives them is a fear of not having enough money, or maybe they've experienced that and they're saying, I'm never going back to that. So it's almost, you know, the argument of what's more of a motivation, the stick or the carrot. I think for this person, when it comes to work, it's fear that drives them rather than a huge sense of enjoyment. We have early riser, and just because what normally comes out with this is insomnia, or what's the card I have? I can't even remember. Something about not sleeping anyway. So I'll see if that comes out as well. So they could have very full, as we know, busy days. They wake up early to get a good head start. We have psychological or emotional impairment. So yeah, like I said, escapism because they're going through something right now. We have employed. Stress at work, I'm seeing that, and we'll take one more. We have single. Okay. There is something changing with your person's 3D reality. I'm seeing work, I'm seeing home or house, I'm seeing relationship if there's a third party on their side. I don't think you can see this yet, and that's why they're trying to get this message to you now, that there's some sort of shift that's happening that's being for now kept quiet. Okay, so let's see what else traits about this person. We have Gemini energy here. June could be a significant time, so maybe something has just happened. Maybe that's when this change began. We have Capricorn, we have Taurus, we have confident, we have impulsive. This person, I think they do come across as confident in one sense or another, but there's this side of them that's very impulsive that I think they repress. It makes them uncomfortable, but sometimes it's very tempting. And look, we have Sagittarius next to this. That's making me think of the King, not King of Wands, Knight of Wands. They want to go on some kind of adventure here. And again, mentally or emotionally unstable, so not feeling very grounded right now. We have masculine. Yep, this is man or woman, someone who really likes to be in charge, but apparently they're saying, I'm happy to let you take the lead in the bedroom. And we have brave and or strong. Yeah, I mean, a lot of people look at this person as someone who is capable, can sort things out. They always have the resources that other people need. And that's great. I think your person derives a sense of accomplishment, achievement, satisfaction and joy from being in that role. But at the same time, there is an immense pressure that they can never drop the ball. They always have to have enough money. They always have to be ready to go at any moment. They always have to be strong. They're never allowed to, you know, wallow for a minute. They're never allowed a moment of overt self-pity. They're never allowed to say, screw it, I'm not doing this, I'm tired. And I think they don't have much room for fun. They're never allowed to do something just because they want to, you know, at least nothing significant. And I think you know this about your person because it's been a big obstacle here is what I'm seeing. So I'm going to leave this here. I hope this has been helpful. In terms of the extended readings, if you do ever purchase one and you have any problems with them, please write to me. Please let me know so I can get you the reading that you have paid for. Otherwise, I will say thank you so much for being here. I hope to see you again soon. I hope, as I said, this has been helpful. So until we meet again, take care. Bye.